It's the 2019 FIA certified Gran Turismo Championships Nations Cup Grand Final. We're at the Nürburgring and the Grand Final race takes place on the Sardinia Road Track A layout. Igor Fraga, the reigning champion, starts on pole position. Alongside him on the front row is Cody Lukowski.
And down in third position behind Cody Lukowski is Coque Lopez, a favourite going into this. Can he convert that third position to take a first Nations Cup win? Giorgio Mangalo in fourth, winner here last year at the Nordschleife. Can he repeat that? Manuel Rodriguez wasn't actually here in the final last year, got knocked out earlier on. Great to see him go one better. Ryan Deruch there in sixth position in the French livery 2019. That is Kononen in seventh, the Finn returning again for a second time here at the Nürburgring. Jonathan Wong, who we mentioned before the start of the show, one to look out for definitely. Adam Sizwillo first in our repercharge, the only British driver in the final. Then in 10th is Beauvoir, he's second in our repercharge event, starting down in 10th position. Then Sugawara, the Japanese driver, what can he do from 11th on the grid? And then seeking at the last moment, Matt Simmons in 12th. Let's see what the Australian driver can do.
Going to be very exciting, this one. Rolling start for these drivers. 20 laps to remind you at this Sardinia road course. Racing hard, medium and soft compound of tyres available. They must use each compound of tyre once over the course of this one. And Igor Fraga going bold early there, Jimmy. He's gone the soft compound of tyres here.
I think of the rare me calling the right strategy there. I think Igor, what he's going to try and do is get up early on that soft compound of tyre and try and put away. So Group X vehicles, this car falls into extreme vehicles, otherwise known as prototypes. They don't fit in any of the racing categories, so be great at one. So there you go. That's how we got around that. That's where the X2019 fits in. Anyway, coming around the last corner now. More of a kink, really, this one in racing trim. You see how close they are now under the rolling start. We shoved it all a bit close together to make it a bit more interesting coming down to T1. Fraga will lead off, but it'll be a slipstream battle down to the first corner. Look how close they all are with this new system. It's great to see. Just waiting for the countdown now. And here it is, 3, 2, 1. And we are go for the grand final here at the Nürburgring World Tour 2. Igor Fraga leads us down to the first corner. And Lopez already ahead of Cody Lukowski. A great move there in the slipstream of Igor Fraga. And Coque Lopez, a great move there, already up to second in the background. Ryan Deruch looking around the outside of Lukowski as well. Mangalo on the inside and push wide. Adam Sizwillo, what a terrible start for the Brit. Already down to the bottom of the order.
Disappointment there for Adam Sizwillo. He'll be ruining that. Meanwhile, Beauvoir versus Jonathan Wong for seventh position. Beauvoir looking up the inside of the Hong Kong driver. He manages to get the position ahead as Lukowski is piling the pressure onto the Spaniard of Coque Lopez. And this is very exciting indeed. Already, Igor Fraga is trying to pull out a gap. He's 8 tenths of a second up the road from Coque Lopez. You'd expect that to be the case, though. He's on the softer compound of tyres like the Spaniard. And those two will have a good pace advantage over the rest of the field as things stand at the moment. So let's see what will happen over the course of this one. Let's see what strategies will take place. Of course, Fraga and Lopez will have to pit in the earlier stages of this race, and they'll have to do the medium and hard compound stints in the latter half, which means they'll be slower towards the end of the race.
So Jonathan Wong just got past Beauvoir there. Matt Simmons already up into ninth position from last, so doing a bit of a repeat from what we saw in the repercharge event. Now, we know that Igor Fraga likes these high downforce cars. I think this is his preference, really. He drives Formula 3 cars in real life. You can see how that kind of translates there a little bit. But as you can see right now, really just putting the gap 2 seconds already to Coque Lopez. Before we even got past the start finish line, there it is on to lap two. Cody Lukowski on the medium compound of tyres, going to kind of be in the no man's land for now. And there's a reminder of the tyre strategy. We didn't catch it at the start of the race. We think that the hard tyre is about 1.5 seconds a lap slower than the soft, with the medium tyre being somewhere in between about 0.5 a second lap slower. And of course, all lasting different durations based on their compound. Here's a replay.
Yep, down in towards the left hander we go, and you can see a bit of contact there taking place. Matt Simmons, Jonathan Wong involved in that incident there, and then resulting in Jonathan Wong losing a few positions. Manuel Rodriguez also in and amongst the mix. There is Igor Fraga. You can see the race leader as things stand. Good start also from Tetsuya Sugawara. He's now managed to get ahead of Manuel Rodriguez on the opening lap, and he's up into sixth position here on lap number two. And Beauvoir actually deemed to be at fault for that penalty, so he's been given a 3 second slowdown penalty for that collision, and subsequently he will have to slow down, of course. 3 seconds when he enters that penalty zone. Fraga leads the way though. Good race from him so far, doing exactly what he needs to do, pulling out that advantage over Coque Lopez. Now just over 3 seconds to the Spaniard.
This is just raw pace from Igor Fraga right now. That's 3 seconds on track alone, essentially. They've not been fighting. Lopez was right up behind Fraga at T1. and the Brazilian driver has just pulled away. He's absolutely showing his dominance in these downforce machines. The X2019 car, of course, the car you're seeing on your screen right now, powered by a V12 engine, which is why it has almost like a shrill to it when it goes by, also with a bit of a different rear aero to what we're used to with the Red Bull X2019. A little bit less aero at the back, so a bit more slippy, a bit more of a challenge for our drivers. So interestingly, in the background here, Sugawara and DeRoute are side by side. Sugawara has the inside line, he'll take the position, and up goes Sugawara in to fifth. A great move by him.
Very nice move from Sugawara. He's on the medium compound tyre, so a faster compound than DeRoute, who's on the harder compound, let's not forget. So there is a bit of a pace advantage there, and Sugawara should, of course, be quicker on that compound tyre in the early stages of this race. So DeRoute there in sixth place, Rodriguez in seventh, Jonathan Wong in eighth. You're looking at Sugawara and DeRoute on the left-hand side of your screen. Don't forget, of course, Sugawara finished third in the repechage, whilst Ryan DeRoute was third in semi-final B. That is how they got on the road to the grand final here tonight.
But interestingly, Giorgio Mangano is only about 1.5 seconds behind Cody Lukoski on that hard compound of the tyre. So Mangano right now is your lead hard tyre runner. So that's something to keep an eye out for, because right now he's getting that hard compound out of the way, so he hasn't got to deal with it later on in the race. And hopefully he'll have even a softer medium and be able to get back onto Igor Fraga or Coco Lopez, who are using their soft tyre early to try and build a gap.
So through the right hander we go, then through the left, very, very fast over the course of this lap. Let's see what will happen as they go down and towards the left hander. We're still riding on board with Sugawara. He's doing a good job there so far, running a little bit wide there out of the left hander, going on towards the start finish straight, but the Japanese driver pulling out that advantage over Ryan DeRouche.
Was that tyre compound advantage being probably the main reason for that at the moment. Can you catch up with Giorgio Mangano? That's the question. Again, Cody Lukoski not really able to pull away from Giorgio Mangano. The gap, if anything, is actually coming down. Speaking of the gaps coming down, Igor Fraga, what's about a second at that? Coco Lopez, what happened there?
Yeah, disappointment there, as you say. So let's keep an eye out and see what happened. Maybe we're going to replay of him running wide or having some kind of an incident. Here is Jonathan Wong. Eighth position for him on the road so far, just behind Manuel Rodriguez. Wong, of course, on the medium compound of tyres. So should be faster than Rodriguez at this early stage of the race. See what will happen over the course of this one. A little bit further back there, you can see two blue livery cars, Marcus Conovin and Matt Simonens. Running on board though in the cockpit with Jonathan Wong. We are, he's now in the slipstream of Manuel Rodriguez, so he will have that pace advantage, as we said, on this medium compound of tyres. Be interesting to see when they decide to pit over the course of this race. Just going through the left-hander, going down hard on the brakes into the left-hander. Side by side they come, up the inside for Jonathan Wong, and seventh position as well.
Great move, dive to the inside right at the last second, didn't even give Manny a chance to defend that. Up seventh goes Jonathan Wong. Great move there by the man, by Hong Kong, as we like to say. So, here we are then. Jonathan Wong in seventh, DeRouche in front in sixth position, but DeRouche does have the tyre disadvantage. Jonathan Wong has a medium compound tyre. Oh, getting it sideways there, so definitely you can't accuse him of not trying, the man from Hong Kong. But can you catch up with Ryan DeRouche before we get to the first set of pit stops? Here's Igor Fraga. So here's what we think happened here, where he lost about a second. Coming through the left-hander, just tipped a barrier on the inside. That shows you how close he was getting here. And also goes back to the point we were making about this track being kind of half a street circuit. Very easy just to drive into the barrier if you aren't careful.
Yep, certainly so. And, well, Igor Fraga doing exactly that. So he'll be wanting to have a bit more of a consistent run in the mid to late stages of this race. Here is Sugawara then, just behind Giorgio Mangano. Sugawara on the medium compound of tyres. Mangano on the harder compound of tyres. So, of course, he'll be a little bit slower at this stage in the race, as is to be expected. Regardless, though, doing a good job of defending so far is Mangano, but Sugawara hasn't put up much of a real threat as things stand at the moment. Coming over the brow of the hill we go, then in towards the fast left-handed kink, and then we go hard on the brakes. This is a very prime overtaking opportunity at this circuit if you're close enough to the drivers behind. Meanwhile, Manuel Rodriguez just listening out there to Jonathan Wong by the looks of things. So the Spanish driver dropping back quite significantly now by 1.9 seconds. Disappointment there for the Spaniard. He would have been hoping for a little bit more in these early stages.
Yeah, of course, also just Willow down in last place there. He was muscled off the course at the first corner and lost about 4 or 5 seconds just from that alone, and now trying to make that back up again. But really, you can't afford to lose that kind of time with this level of competition. Now, the gap between Igor Fraga and Coco Lopez in the front of the field is kind of stabilised, about 1.5 seconds now, so there is a bit of a result or a comeback there for Coco Lopez. Here's Sugawara and Mangano in the slipstream. Wow, that's from a long way back. Sugawara goes up the inside of Mangano, passing like he's standing still, using that tyre advantage to to his best bet there, and Froome goes up into fourth position. Great move there.
Ryan DeRouche now in the pit lane, the first driver to make a pit stop in this race. He's now going off from the harder compound to the softer compound of tyre, so he'll get a very short stint out of that one, then be on the hard compound right at the, or the medium compound I should say rather, right at the very end of this race. So let's see whether that strategy is going to be something that will pay off for the Frenchman, who emerges out onto the track now behind his fellow countrymen. See Tetsuya Sugawara, Giorgio Mangano on the left-hand side of your screen. Sugawara doing a really good job as he comes under the bridge, down in towards the left-hander, which follows, and that medium compound of tyre seems to be working quite well. It's a bit of a happy medium, if you'll pardon the expression, and it allows the drivers to have a good amount of pace, but also have a good amount of tyre life there as well. This man here, though, Igor Fraga, still keeping a consistent pace over the course of this one. He set personal best first and second sectors, so that softer compound of tyre still performing pretty well.
I think what it's going to be for these guys at the front is how long can they make that soft compound of tyre last. It's almost a little bit opposite from what you expect when you watch these races, because the guys will go further on the soft compound of tyre than they will on the hard compound, just because the hard is that much slower. I think if the race distance was longer, the hard tyre would probably be more of an option for a lot of drivers, but it's actually important they get out there and just have the laps in there. You can see in the bottom left hand corner Portuguese commentators. Great to have them here. Again, we have seven languages in total commentating on this race, so really is available to everyone to watch if you're interested in tuning in to eSports. You should be, because this stuff is fantastic.
It really is, and Igor Fraga, a lot of hometown support, a little bit sideways there, though, so maybe that softer compound of tyre just starting to get a little bit more on the edge. Adam Zaswillo is in the pit lane now as well. He goes from the harder compound to the medium compound of tyres. His first pit stop is made. He now emerges in last position in this race. I tell you what, I absolutely adore the sound that this Red Bull X29 team makes as well. The V12 engine popping and banging on the overrun as they slow down and shift down that gearbox.
Yeah, definitely it's one of the most notable cars in the game. I think it's very fair to say that. Fraga will come around the last real corner, I would say, a bit of a hairpin before coming to the kick at the final straight. Now, when you peel into the pits, how much longer can these guys make the soft tyres last? Fraga Lopez still there in the background, there or thereabouts, and there we go, soon to say it. Fraga ducks into the pit lane with a soft tyre. Will Lopez? Lopez is going to go round again. That's really interesting. Now, I wonder if Lopez can make that soft tyre last and get the lap time out of it, or will Igor Fraga get the undercut on the medium compound of tyre and even take a bit more of a gap out of the Spaniard behind? So even more pit stops going on. Giorgio Mangano in for the medium tyre. Sugawara opting to go for the soft compound of tyre. So pit stops coming thick and fast now.
Simmons and Rodriguez also in the pit lane there, changing from the medium and hard to hard and the hard to medium respectively. Bouvoir in the pit lane, so lots of drivers following the same tact as Igor Fraga there as they shift over. Fraga emerges on that medium compound, so as you said, Jimmy, he'll be on the harder compound of tyres at the end of this race. Now, I wonder what Lopez is going to be doing here. Will he go from the soft to the mediums like Fraga? Will he go from the soft to the harder compound of tyre and be on the quicker compound at the end of the race? So lose a bit in the mid stages, and then in the latter stages, be on the faster compound of tyres whilst Fraga is going to have to struggle around.
Only he knows that right now, so we'll have to wait and see what he does at the moment. But what I do know is that this lap is crucial. But Coque Lopez seems to be as quick as he can on these soft tyres. They'll be very worn at this point, so the car won't be responding the way it did at the start of the stint, and he'll have to adapt to that as we go on. Coming round the last hairpin now, and now the run down to the start finish line continues. So what we'll like to see here is him pit in, come in for a new set of tyres. What will they be? Will they be the medium tyres like Fraga, or will they be the hard? Here he comes into the pit lane. Coque Lopez, what will he do?
Into the pit box he comes. As you say, Jimmy's on the soft. He goes to the medium compound. He follows exactly the same tactics as the former race leader. This man here, Igor Fraga Lakowski, also in the pits, but he goes from the medium to the harder compound. So he's going to be on the softs at the end of this race. Now, that is going to be a very interesting strategy, because he'll be arguably one of the fastest men on the circuit. Lopez emerges, and Fraga goes straight that pass. So it wasn't quite a good enough outlap, or that continuous lap, rather. It was a great outlap for Igor Fraga on the other side of the coin, and he emerges in the lead of the race.
Can't help but wonder the Spanish guys are rooting for. I'm not sure they're being subtle with the old Spanish flag around the neck. Lakowski comes out the pit lane, and Sugawara on that soft compound of tyre, absolutely charging, takes Lakowski there, and up to third goes the Japanese driver. We didn't really expect to see that when he came up the pit lane. I mean, fortunately for Lakowski, That can happen at the right time. He's probably going to get overtaken anyway. That tyre difference is enough to really make the overtaking quite easy for the soft compound runner. But of course, you never like to lose a place. But now he's not having this problem. He won't lose any additional time because the costly strategy, I think, is to have a fast finish. So let's try and keep out of trouble now. So here is a replay. Sugawara.
How far back he came from as well. He was
Size of pit lane.
In closing split lane. Closing speed, as you say, then Jimmy and Jeff. Straight up the inside of Lukowski and sent it up the inside and into that podium position for Sugawara. So doing a really good job. He's on the faster compound of tyres by a significant margin. Sugawara on the soft, Lukowski on the harder compound. So he is going to be a lot slower as we sit in this mid-stage of the race, but he'll be on the soft compound at the end of this race. Now, is that going to be a strategy that pays dividends for the Australian driver, or will it be one that doesn't work out for him? Let's keep an eye on things, see how they go. Ryan Deruch, meanwhile, he's had a quiet race so far, but he's in fifth position. He's doing great things as well in terms of closing the gap to Lukowski. Soft compound of tyres for the Frenchman, so you would expect that to be the case. Let's see how fast he can close up on Lukowski, or when he will find his way past. It'll be interesting. We're now at the halfway stage in this race. Igor Fraga still leads the way. 2.1 seconds he is now ahead of Koke Lopez. Both drivers on similar strategies. Lopez, though, his tyres are going to be a lap younger than Igor Fraga, so both will be on the hard compound of tyres at the very end of this race. A little bit wide there for Koke Lopez as well, just making a slight error as he came out of that right-hander.
Yeah, I mean, a couple of attempts gone there for the Spaniards. He'll be upset with that, but it's no big deal. He'll be able to put it back in easy enough, of course. Now, these guys are going to have to go as long as they can now on this medium compound of tyre. No one really wants to be on that hard compound of tyre, but they have to use it. It's in the rules. You have to use all three tyre compounds. And Fraga and Lopez are our current leaders on track. Still have the hard compound yet to run. Meanwhile, behind them, Sugawara on the soft compound is starting to catch him slightly, but he'll have to pit in fairly soon. The soft compound doesn't last too long before it starts falling off. And then in fourth is Cody Lukowski. Now, he's on a bit of an opposite strategy, really, to the guys in front. So right now, he's going to be slower. He's dropped off. I mean, really, he's about, using my terrible math skills, about 10 seconds, 9 seconds off the leader right now is Lukowski. But he'll have a fast finish on that soft compound of tyre, so may even pull that back. But that remains to be seen.
So here is Sugawara, the man on the move at the moment and about to set one of the fastest laps, in fact, the fastest lap of the race, a 1:25.137. Very impressive lap time there from the Japanese driver. So he is fast on that soft compound of tyres and is closing that gap down to the two leaders of this race as things stand. Through the left hand we go, then in towards the right. Fraga doing a really good job of keeping that gap at a constant to Koke Lopez. Now just under 2 seconds, it dips for the first time in a very long while. You can see there Cody Lukowski, meanwhile, is losing time at the moment hand over fist as Ryan Deruch behind is on the softer compound of tyres, and this could really disrupt Lukowski's race if Deruch is able to find his way past. Let's see what will happen though. Getting close is one thing, as we know, but getting past is quite enough.
Luckily in these cars, it's quite a big six-speed effect. So if you get up behind the car in front, it's quite easy just to tuck in behind them, use the toe and drop by. Of course, cars with more aero kind of puncture, they disturb the air more, so to speak, than the kind of conventional saloon car. So following one of these cars, it's worth a lot of speed down the straight. So there you go, there is the gap visually then. So you have Fraga, Lopez, Sugawara, who is putting onto the back of these guys on that soft compound of tyre. Now, what Sugawara really needs to do is get ahead of these guys and disturb them a little bit. Just maybe force them into a mistake. Don't think too much about lap time, just get them disturbed. And at the moment, they're on a great strategy. Sugawara is kind of the one who's going to be off strategy. He's going to be going onto a hard tyre at the end. So he needs to really get up there, get in there, and just mix it up a bit, really.
Absolutely. Ryan Deruch, meanwhile, has called it quits on that soft compound of tyres. He goes into the pit lane for a set of new boots. His final pit stop in this race will be a medium set of tyres on board his Red Bull X2019. Here, though, are your three leaders in shot for the first time of Arshu. There are the Japanese commentators, Yamada-san on the left, Nakajima-san on the right-hand side. They'll be rooting for Tetsuya Sugawara to do a good job and try and disrupt these two race leaders. The Spanish commentators there, I wonder who they're rooting for. You can see the Spanish flag around their neck and the German commentators here of Mikkel and Florian, who are very, very excited to be here. Shame that their nation is not being represented in this Nations Cup final, with a disappointment for Mikhail Hazal. He Igor Fraga holding onto that race lead. It's come down over the last couple of laps now, down by 0.3 seconds to 1.7 seconds is the gap between himself and Koke Lopez. He's used to have found a little bit more speed, but the man who's on the charge, Tetsuya Sugawara, could be ready to upset the apple cart here. And if he can get himself ahead, if he can force them into a mistake, he'll not only be ahead on the road, but he could be in a very good contention here to challenge for this race victory.
So watch this, Sugawara now will have a little bit of a toe coming down the main straight. Will he be staying out on that soft compound tyre? He is for now, yes. And watch that gap come down on the left-hand side of your screen, down by 0.3 seconds, nearly 0.4 seconds coming down in T1. Nearly touching 300 kilometres an hour, and then machine gunning back down through the gears. They have to be so quick on the downshift in this thing. It accelerates almost as quickly as it decelerates. And now on board with Tatsuya Sugawara, both in the game and on the left-hand side of your screen. Taking a couple of bites at the turn into the corner, but otherwise looking very calm and collected. So they have to also be careful when following someone in front, because although you do get a little bit of a toe coming down the slope, which of course benefits your straight line speed, you also end up getting a little bit disturbed through the faster corners using the dirty air. So it's a bit of a double-edged sword getting close to the guy in front, but again coming down the straight, gaining time, down to half a second, not quite close enough to make a move right now, but it's all about setting up for the last part of the lap.
Get towards that left hand and into that final part of the lap. We will be coming towards now, so let's see whether Sugawara can make a move. It will surely be at the start of the next lap. And let's think about when Lopez and Fraga are going to be pitting once again. They're on that medium compound. They're going to have to change over to the hard before too long. And they're going to be slow, don't forget, on this last part of the race. Into the left-hander we go. Onto the straight we come for the 13th time of asking out of 20 here in the grand final for the Nations Cup. Through the right-hander kink and onto that start finish race. And surely Sugawara is going to have the slipstream. I don't know if he's going to be close enough though. He's in the slipstream with Lopez. Lopez defends his line, but surely Sugawara is going to think about it. He's very close indeed. He's closer than he's been. He dives towards the inside, but Lopez shuts the door on him. He doesn't allow an opportunity as Lakowski and Mangano pit.
Not quite close enough. I mean, he was almost there, but I think what he's trying to do there is just say, hey, look behind you, you know, just try and distract him a little bit as opposed to actually go for the move seriously. Fraga had a terrible first sector. The gap now down between the top three, down to a second. And Sugawara now looking very, very handy in this. Now, if you are Sugawara, what you want to do now is go as long as you can, if it's possible. Try and match these guys on the medium. Keep that soft tyre alive for as long as possible and then go on to the hard at the end, because that way it's an equal playing field. Here we go, they're coming to the hill. Lopez now looking to the outside of Igor Fraga, who goes defensive, looks around the outside. The top two are now side by side. Fraga keeps the position on the defensive one on the inside. That allows Sugawara behind to get even closer. So now this battle for first has come alive with what seems to be a mistake for Fraga in the first part of a lap.
So this is very close indeed. So the top three leaders in this race at the moment are running nearly nose to tail. You can see Igor Fraga there. His characteristically smooth driving style is helping him out here. But that gap, as you said, Jimmy, came down quite significantly over the last lap or so. He's building it up again as Koke Lopez had a little bit of a slide going out of that penultimate corner. And you can see Sugawara is going to be challenging against Koke Lopez for second position. He's in the slipstream. He's going to go over the brow of the hill through that left-handed kink. And surely Sugawara is going to look to the inside. But again, not close enough. Doesn't even think about chancing a move there.
Tyres, I think, are gone on that now, Tom. I think he's now really starting to struggle to get those tyres working the way he wants them to. So he's just trying to stay behind Lopez. I say that, he chucks it up the inside. Maybe I should just quit this whole commentary gig, Tom. There he goes, but now they're side by side. Lopez fighting back there. Sugawara is forced off into the grass. These things really don't like the grass, I can tell you that now. And I thought that was a move made there, but I think that really caught Lopez by surprise. Sugawara just kind of just chucked it into the corner. The door was open, he walked through it, but then Lopez forced him out wide as an exit and defended the position, which luckily for Igor Fraga has given him a bit of a breather.
Hard but fair defending there from Koke Lopez, exactly what he needed to do, exactly what he wanted to do. And as you said, Christmas coming early there for Igor Fraga, just allowing him a little bit more breathing space out in front in the lead of this race. Now, when are Fraga and Lopez going to pit? Are they going to go for the same strategy? Are they going to pit on the same lap? Or is it going to be a little bit different from either of them? Will they pit on separate laps like we saw last time? Will Lopez be the first driver to blink?
My guess is the hard tyre is so slow that Lopez will use that one lap advantage he had on the fresher tyre and maybe try and make it a double. Doing stuff like that, getting the car sideways, is not going to help conserve your tyres. Let's see what happens. So Fraga there comes in. He's going to dive into the pit lane for a set of new hard tyres. So there goes Fraga. Lopez goes for the extra lap. Sugawara comes in, so he's going to try and match Fraga. That's really interesting. So what might happen here, this is definitely a possibility, if the medium tyres for Lopez are just gone, at this point. We might see Fraga and Sugawara go past on the undercut.
This is going to be very exciting indeed. Sugawara has to take on fuel, though, for his stop. He's going to be longer than Fraga, so it's going to be a bit of an interesting one, that, because he will come out with more of a gap to make up to the Brazilians. Suswillo also in the pit lane there as well. He makes his final stop and goes from the medium to the softer compound of tyres. Meanwhile, Matt Simmons also in the box from the hard to the softer compound at the end of this race. Let's see what their pace is going to be like and see what charging they're going to be able to do. Koke Lopez, though, needs the lap of his life at this stage. He's got a 17-second advantage over Igor Fraga. That's not going to be enough to have a pit stop in hand. There is Fraga back out on track, back out on the harder compound of tyres. The advantage that he will have on this harder compound of tyres, the only advantage he will have, is he'll have one more lap of experience of understanding that car and a lap of heat in those tyres as well. He won't have to spend a few corners getting it up to temperature like Koke Lopez will. So, through the left-hander we go, down in towards this final corner on the lap, penultimate corner on the lap, and then into the final right-handed kick. So surely this is when Lopez is going to pit. He's going to have to. Those tyres are going to be second-hand at the moment. Lopez coming out through that final corner now, and surely he will be going into the pit lane for his final stop, and indeed he does. So Lopez into the box for the last time onto the hard compound of tyres.
So here it is, the decider. Who will come out in first position? There'll be a little bit of fuel going on board there, I think, for Koke Lopez as well. So what is this pit stop going to bring to this race? Igor Fraga out, Cody Lukoski on the soft compound attire. He's charging as well. Out comes Lopez. Will Fraga retain the lead? Look to the left of your screen. Lopez is out ahead of Fraga. That was a bad outlap for Igor Fraga. And in the background, here comes the Brazilian now, but Koke Lopez inherits the lead. And now it's a three-lap sprint to the line. Look at the background though, Tom. Lukoski on the soft compound attire is only 4 seconds behind this.
And I tell you what though, Sugawara has lost out massively here, having to take fuel on board in his final stop. Jimmy, he was battling potentially for the race lead a couple of laps ago, but Lukoski and DeRouge, who are on the soft and medium of compound attires respectively, have managed to leapfrog the Japanese driver. And look at the Spanish commentators of Ricardo and Alberto here. They are full of passion and full of vigour for the man who is leading the race, of Koke Lopez. Now it is a head-to-head scrap right to the checkered flag for the race lead, and of course, crucially, the place in the grand final in November for the Gran Turismo World Tour.
Tell you what, we said it earlier, Koke Lopez, one to watch, and now he is only 2.5 laps away from taking a win here at the Nürburgring, but in his mirrors, big in his mirrors, is last year's Nations Cup champion, Igor Fraga, real-life F3 driver. You can see him on the left-hand side of your screen there, looking relatively calm, but definitely doesn't feel like it at the moment, I'm sure. Runs it a bit wide there, actually, on the exit. A little bit of pressure. Igor's coming under, and the gap now at about a second. We've had a little bit of slip stream down the straight here, but not enough to challenge into T1. Meanwhile, Cody, that gap has come down by 2 seconds on that lap alone, so this is going to turn into a three-way scrap for the win here. Look, he's back in the background. Look how close he is now. Here we go, Tom. Another race coming down to the wire.
2.5 seconds is the gap to Igor Fraga from Cody Lukoski. So let's see what he'll be able to do. He's going to have a good pace advantage. Did you say there, Jimmy? It's about 0.7 of a second a lap, if not a little bit more, for the Australian driver. Lopez leading the way. It's about 1.5 seconds, in fact, is the gap between the compound of tyres from the hard to the soft. So surely Lukoski is going to be in the pound seats here in these last two laps of racing in the grand final at the Nürburgring, being held here at the Sardinia Road Course. So Fraga versus Lopez is what we saw, thought we'd see to the checkered flag, but Lukoski has cut that gap down by 1 second over the last couple of corners in this first sector alone.
You see Lopez weaving from side to side, just trying to break the toe to Igor Fraga. That's pretty much what happens here. These cars are really effective in a toe, and now Igor is right on the back of Koke Lopez, and they're getting the background. Cody's getting ever closer. So now coming down to the hairpin, a great spot to overtake if you bounce here, but Fraga there actually chooses to drop away a bit, and Lukoski pushing a bit too hard in the background and clouting the barrier. Didn't slow him down too much, but there's always a risk of being a penalty.
He'll live to fight another day, Will Lukoski. He's got such a pace advantage now, down to under a second for the first time to the race leaders. So this three-way scrap is going to get very exciting indeed. Lopez tries to duck and dummy himself into the pit lane as Fraga comes over the timing line just behind Koke Lopez. And the thing is as well, whilst these two are scrapping, it's not going to help Cody Lukoski. Lukowski in any way, shape or form. Sorry, it is going to help Cody Lukowski in every single way, shape and form, because it's going to allow him to close up even further. There is Koke Lopez. There are the Brazilian commentators. Lucas Ordonez in the middle of your picture there as well. Ryan DeRouche, meanwhile, and Giorgio Mangano battling for position. And DeRouche is ahead of Mangano as things stand at the moment. But Sugawara is also very close behind the Italian for the top five position. Now Lopez on the defensive. He needs to defend with every fibre in his body. He's running a little bit wide. He's exceeding track limits ever so slightly and trying to make his Red Bull X2019 as wide as he possibly can. So Lopez there in the race lead. Fraga just less than 3/10 of a second behind. Lukowski in third position. This is so close, and we're on the penultimate lap of racing here at the Sardinia road course. It is going to go down to the wire, you can guarantee it. Yep, absolutely right. So through the left hander we go then, and in towards the final couple of corners. Here comes Lukowski. He has a sneaky look up the inside of Fraga. They're side by side. He's up the inside. He's pushing in wide. And Lukowski gets into second position. He's ahead of Igor Fraga. And we come onto the final lap of racing here. And Fraga immediately darts back into the slipstream. He wants to try and get himself back ahead of Lukowski with any opportunity. But Lukowski will not want to take this line down. He'll want to get himself ahead of the race leader, Koke Lopez, onto the final lap of racing. We are. Lukowski's a bit wide though. Oh, it nearly cost him a little bit of time there.
Yes, Lukowski there, right on the back of Koke Lopez. Igor Fraga though, demoted to third position. Now, what can Lukowski do on these soft compound tyres? Koke Lopez is going to have it all to do now. He has the tyre disadvantage. He has Lukowski, a charging Koke Lukowski right up his rear wing. And we know how effective the Australian driver can be now. Coming on to the second to back straight, we'll have a toe up here. Koke Lopez will likely go defensive to the inside, try and break the toe. No, not quite close enough for now. And it's all going to be all down to the wire. Three to the line, Tom.
So then, in towards the final sector we go for the last time of arting. Lopez very defensive. Lukowski has to try and invent something. He's so close, they're running nose to tail. Lukowski nearly spins. He loses out. Will he be able to try and invent something into these final couple of corners? It's going to be Lopez and Fraga then to the line. Through the left-hander we go, and it's going to be absolutely amazing. What a Nations Cup final we have. Lopez defensive, Fraga tries the long way round. Lukowski into the back of Lopez. Big drama, and Fraga and Lukowski go to the line. So close between them, and Fraga through the right-handed kick. Surely he's got this one. Igor Fraga wins the Nations Cup final. Over the line he comes. Fraga is on top. A brilliant race from the Brazilian driver. Lukowski in second, DeRouche in third. But the results, I can tell you, are under investigation following that race. Well, big, big drama right in the final corner. Gran Turismo Sport never disappoints. The World Tour 2 does not disappoint here, Jimmy. That was absolutely insane in every sense of the word.
I mean, you can see the reaction of Koke Lopez there.